This is Erz, and I'm going to take you through CloudBees feature management demo. On the right side, we have a demo application that we're using. This is a front-end web application. This is a music application. We have various artists that we can listen to their music. And on the left side, we have our CloudBees feature management dashboard. And in this demo, I'm going to enable a few feature flags or few features that are already gated behind some feature flags. So looking at the left side, this is our SaaS dashboard, and on the left side, we have the main navigation menu. Under flags over here, we have environments, and we're currently in production. And these are the flags that I've already defined in the code. And just to show you this, I'm gonna jump to the code. This is a JavaScript application, and we have an object over here that has all the flags. So going back to the demo, what I'm going to do is I'm going to enable a flag that is currently gated behind the feature flag. So following view, I'm going to go to this screen, and you can see that this feature following view is currently turned off. It's false for everybody. And if I'm going to go on the right side on the application to this specific artist, you can see that there's an empty space on the right side. I'm going to enable a feature over here. So I'm gonna just set this to true, and I'm gonna save and activate targeting. Let's wait for this to happen. And now I'm gonna come over here and refresh, and we are going to see a new feature over here. So this is just an easiest implementation of a feature flag. I'm gonna show you a more common use case where we set this to false, and then we decide to enable this feature to a handful of the user base. So to do so, I'm gonna add a condition. And instead of deploying this or releasing this to everybody, I just want to release this to a subset of the user base. So instead of all users, I'm going to select target group. I've already defined a group of users that I want to deploy to. So I'm going to select internal employees and QA team. And for them, I'm going to set this to true. And then you could see that if you're in either one of these groups, you're gonna get the true value, otherwise you're gonna get the false value. And I'm gonna save this. Now, you're probably asking yourself, well, what are these groups of users? How are those defined? So to do so, I'm gonna jump to target groups. And you can see that I have three groups that I've defined over here: internal employees, QA team, and then power users. And each of those is defined separately. So internal employees is defined using the email property and with a regex. And then everybody that has the CloudBees domain is going to be in this group of users. The QA team is defined by specific user emails. And then power users is defined by playlist count. So we're looking at the application property called playlist count. And if that is larger than 100, you're going to be in this group of users. Now I'm gonna go back to production and to the following view of flag that we've enabled, and I'm gonna add a new condition. What I wanna do now is open this feature also to my power users, but for them, I wanna have just a 10% deployment. So I'm gonna use split and then 10% deployment. And this is kind of a drag and drop interface. So I wanna make sure that internal employees are getting this, I can drag this rule to the top and I can save. And essentially what I've done now is I've created a rule set that would say, if you're an internal employee or a QA user, you're gonna get the true value. If you are a power user, 10% are gonna get the true value, otherwise you're gonna get the false value and everybody else would get false. And by the way, the 10% over here is consistent. So if you're in that bucket, you're gonna stay in that bucket. So this is kind of the basic implementation of feature flags. What I want to show you is some of the management capabilities. Aside from the environments, you could also have an audit log, which allows you to view all the feature flags changes that were done on an environment level and in a specific time period. You could also view this on a specific flag. So if you go to a specific flag and you look at the audit log, you could look at the changes in the context of this flag only. And again, you could use a time period for that. Another thing you could do is that we allow you to see the impression. So how many times a flag is being evaluated, and then what's the distribution across the value. And you could see that over here kind of in a smaller fashion, But then if you go in and you look at the impression, you could look at more details over here, and you could list, you could look at this in different time spans. The last thing I'm going to talk about is some of the other management capabilities. So one of the things that we've recently added is the ability to group a bunch of features together. And you can see that there is a feature column over here, and the history, repeat, and shuffle have the player feature labeled to them. If I click on this, basically I get grouped all the features, all the flags that are under this feature, and there's a description over here. And these are all features or feature flags that are associated with the same feature. Soon enough, we'll have the capability to override from this screen all the internal rules that are happening on this, on these flags, and to have a holistic way of controlling a specific feature. So this is what I have for you today, guys. Thank you.